all part of the national park. Stirling Trust have a very good effect on the landscape. It's going to make a mess, so they projected them. They became kings of England. At the start of the Jacobite period, if you look over here at this farm, you'll see an old ruined castle in the front of it.
Very, very small, just a tower.
Well, that's 6 days late taking their oath to King William. In February 1692, the very start of the month, a militia was making their way through Glen Coe from Fort William. The militia was led by Robert Campbell of Glen Lyon, a Highlander. But it was half Highland, half Lowland. There was English there as well. And they were basically government troops. And they asked for, "You will put your plan into execution. You will fall upon the rebels and McKean McDonalds of Glen Coe and leave none alive under the age."
It tends to be much warmer here. That's because we have the Gulf Stream going all the way around the coast, or the North Atlantic Drift, heating up the water, heating up the air, so it gives us a much milder climate, sometimes, and also gives us, because we're sitting right on the edge of the continental shelf, we have, where the North Sea drops into the Atlantic, very, very rich marine life out there. We have whales and dolphins and more boy.
It's a lovely house here, it's all boarded up. It was covered in graffiti for a while.
It belonged to a very, very horrible man called Jimmy Savile. Some of you may have heard of, all over the press. He was a DJ with the BBC, and he was protected by the BBC as well for a number of years, but he turned out to be one of the worst sexual offenders in the whole history of the UK. He was preying on people in hospitals and everything. He ran charities and things, and people who were disabled and all sorts in hospitals couldn't do anything about him. And he hid behind the fact he was a superstar. But they caught him and half of the BBC were doing the same. And he goes a stage further. He goes from being a cattle dealer to a cattle thief in the 60s. And also, if you look down in the valley, you'll see a road covered over in grass. Here. That's the old military road built by General George Wade during their Jacobite period, early 1700s, all part of the ethnic cleansing of the Highlands, the removal of the people from the Highlands, and they used it to persecute the clans. They had to take their troops into the north so they can get control of the Highlands, so they built a massive road network through the Highlands. The Marquess is desperate to catch Rob Roy. He's having no luck at all. Rob Roy is leading him on a merry dance. And all this is getting reported in newspapers down in Glasgow, down in Edinburgh, London as well. And Rob Roy starts to build up a fan base. People love to read about the exploits of this Highland rogue, as he's been called now, evading capture from the mighty Marquess of Montrose. But eventually,